What is a normal vector? Because oftentimes when you're dealing with raycast or maybe some other 3D stuff in Roblox and in other domains, you will have to use a normal. They're incredibly useful, but they're also kind of confusing, especially since the name doesn't really mean much. And in linear algebra and other mathematical domains, you have norms, normal and normalized, which all mean different things, even though they're the same word. But we're going to talk about normal vectors today. So what is a normal vector? Let's say you have a plane in 3D space. This is like all the three axes. So this is your plane. And the plane has a normal vector. Its normal would be kind of like this. So this drawing kind of sucks because I'm a bad drawer. But the whole idea here is a normal vector is a vector that is perpendicular to the plane. Now, we draw it like an arrow, like here, because it points the direction. But a normal is nothing more than a direction. If you were to like actually plot the normal on three axes on its own, it would literally just be a vector. Could be here, could be there, could be wherever. But we draw it on top of the plane to make it like so then. That's the plane's direction. And you use normals to define a plane because there's only like three vectors that you can like deal with in 3D space to like make things relative to other things. You have like the normal vector, and then you have like the two other vectors on the plane. Actually, let's draw this in a different color. So you have like the two other vectors on the plane like this. But it's easier to define a plane using this one normal vector as opposed to the two other vectors because they have to be orthonormal, meaning like they're perpendicular, and they have to be like unit vectors. Yeah, a normal vector doesn't really have to be a unit vector, although in Roblox it is just for convenience for a lot of situations. But essentially, it's just a vector perpendicular to the plane. Now, let's hop into Roblox and see what exactly that means. So here in Roblox, I have a little setup. I have a part, which this part is going to cast a ray onto this other part, which is a plane. They're all anchored, all kind of like default parts. I just kind of colored them. So the goal for us is to kind of experiment with the normal stuff. And in this, you know, ray casting part, I have a script. The script, basically, what it does is it... Don't disregard that part. The script, what it does is it has a part, and you make a ray cast in the look vector. So we're casting just 100 studs forward at the part dot position towards, like, where it's looking. And make sure, if you're trying to replicate what I'm doing, make sure that the front face, so right-click show orientation indicator, this little F, is pointing at the plane that you want to hit. And then for now, I guess, let's just print the cast.normal. Can't really hurt. So what we can do is we can run it. And you print cast.normal. You get a normal down here. Yippee. And I also have this part here. Well, we're going to make a new one just so I can show you it. It's going to be a kind of indicator. So we want to make a little indicator part for our normal vectors. So I'm going to... show orientation indicator, make sure I'm making the front face kind of like the narrow, skinny one. So I'm going to kind of narrow that down. We're going to make it 0.1, 0.1, 1. So it's just kind of small. Make it red. And then neon. So this part is going to be kind of like an indicator of where our normal is. So I'm going to edit the pivot. I'm going to drag the pivot to the back of the part away from the front face. Make sure it's centered like that. Just so we can like make it look like a vector, like with direction. And then I'm going to anchor it. And we're going to call this part the normal part. And then in the script, we're going to get the normal part. I'm going to say local normal part equals workspace.normal part. And then we're going to set the normal part dot, or we're going to pivot to normal part pivot to cframe.lookalong. So we're going to start at a position and look along a direction vector, which in this case is a normal, because a normal is nothing more than a direction that's perpendicular to the plane. And to start, we're going to make it at 0. So we're going to make vector 3.0, so that's 0, 0, 0. So it's going to start at the origin and just kind of point. It's going to point towards the cast.normal. So let's see what this does. So if you kind of look, the... parts over here kind of pointing this way. and then the plane is over here. And you can see sort of similar, but like this is what a normal vector is. The normal vector is just a normal vector. So that was a very bad statement. The normal vector is a regular vector. Sorry. It's a regular vector that's just like sitting at the origin. It's a direction. It doesn't have position. It's not anywhere. If you want to visualize the normal vector on the actual plane, you can actually set the position to the cast.position. So that'll put it where the cast actually hits. Well, if I stop it and we rerun it. So it'll put it where the cast actually hits. So you see how this normal vector is, you know, more or less exactly perpendicular to the plane. And if we were to like rotate the plane, like so, just kind of like angle it about, you know, doesn't really matter, just to see something else. We run it again. The normal vector is now in a different spot, facing a different direction. But you'll notice if I were to move like this part here, really the position should change, but the normal vector shouldn't. And the normal vector is still in like the same position. So again, all the normal vector is a vector perpendicular to the plane that it sits on. So I'm using a big part for this, but like, for example, if you have like a wedge and you cast it like this direction, the normal vector will still just like, you know, be facing out and up. And I'm just using this plane for demonstration purposes. But that's really it for normals. They're not scary. They're not hard to use. And once you have this direction, you're able to do pretty cool things like order something or move something to like the plane and like make it sit on the plane as if it were the ground and stuff like that, like just depending on raycast. Like I use this for the like the laser bouncing video to like kind of bounce the lasers across like mirrors. So that looks pretty cool. So this is the same exact idea. So I really hope you enjoyed this quick little informational video. Let me know if you want any more little quickies like this to get some info out. But with that, like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Hope you have a nice day. And goodbye.